Hello, welcome to this podcast. Today we will be treating the parable of the wheat and the weeds from Matthew chapter 13, verse 24. And I'll read. He presented another parable to them. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seeds in the field. But whilst people were sleeping, his enemy came, sowed weeds among the wheat, and left. When the plant sprouted and produced grain, then the weeds also appeared. The landowner's slaves came to him and said, "Master, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Then where did the weeds come from?" "An enemy did this," he told them. "So do you want us to go and gather them up?" The slaves asked him. "No," he said. "When you gather up the weeds, you might also uproot the wheat with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. At harvest time, I will tell the reapers, 'Gather the weeds first and tie them in bundles to burn them, but store the wheat in my barn.'" The Bible tells us in Matthew about a sower who sowed seeds in a field. Well, if you're a Bible student, you understand that the seed is simply the Word of God. In Peter, we understand that the seed, which is the Word of God, is incorruptible. And therefore, the Word of God is incorruptible and always a good seed. One of the things I found out is the most important thing that we need to find out from the scriptures that is very consistent is the seed, which is the Word of God. And the Word of God is spoken to us every day. And the Bible tells us that the sower sowed in a field. He sowed the Word of God. The field is like coming to church. When you receive the Word of God from the pastor, he is sowing a seed into the field. But the Bible says that something happened after the sower, the farmer, who is the sower, sowed the seed. What happened was, the Bible says that men slept. Whilst men slept, the enemy came and sowed tares among the good seed that had already been sowed. Which means that whilst we sleep, sometimes the Word of God, which is becomes the seed that God has given us, get corrupted. The enemy here represents the devil, that the devil came and sowed tares among the good seed that God already sowed in our hearts. For example, there was a time when God spoke to me and he said that he was going to do certain things in my life. Well, because I refused to pray about it and I refused to meditate on God's word about what God has said to me, what happened was that I received tares from the enemy. The enemy started sowing tares, which is doubt. The enemy started sowing those things in my heart. And so because of that, what the Word of God that had been spoken to me by God that was going to come to pass started to actually dwindle down, started to die in my own life because I had allowed the enemy to sow tares among the Word of God that I had already received. Well, the question is this, that when we receive God's word, which is incorruptible, which is a seed that will never die, which is incorruptible, and we sleep over it, we allow the enemy to sow doubts into our field, which already has the Word of God. Now, the reason why tares are very dangerous to the seed is that the tares competes with the seed, which was the wheat. It competes with it for nutrients. And because it competes with it for nutrients, what happens is that what will happen is that it will kill the amount of fruits that the wheat will bear, or it will totally kill the wheat itself. And so it is very important for us to keep every word that God gives to us, because the enemy is looking for it to sow tares among them. Okay, but the Bible says that the servant saw that the tares had been sowed and they were growing together with the wheat. And they asked the master a question. Now, before I get into that, you need to understand something. The Bible says that when the enemy came and sowed the tares, it wasn't seen until it's both the wheat and the tares started to grow. Because a lot of times, increase will allow us to see certain flaws in our lives. The more something increases, we see the flaws bigger and more. It's amplified in our eyes. For example, there are many things that we point out about celebrities or politicians or people in the limelight. And one of the reasons why this is so is because every time you increase, whatever flaws or whatever sins or whatever is in your life also increases and magnifies in the eyes of people. And so increase always shows you the tears in your life. Every time you begin to get increase, you will see a lot of times where the devil has tried to sow tears in your life. But the Bible tells us that the master told the servants, do not go and plug out the tares, because you might plug out both the wheat whilst you're trying to plug out the tares. And I'll tell you why. The reason why he said don't do that is because the roots of the tares always intermingles with the roots of the wheat, so that if you don't take care, you might think that you're only taking out the tares, but you eventually take out the wheat in the process of trying to take out the tares. And the other reason is that whilst you do that, you might destroy the wheat entirely. And the master didn't want that to happen. So he told them something. He said, wait till the harvest time. When the harvest time comes, you will know the wheat from the tares. And as much as the seed is the word of God, the seed is the word of God, and the tares is the doubt that the devil sows. The Bible tells us explicitly that the master says that we should not pluck out the tares until harvest time. So I ask myself, doesn't the master see that the wheat, the tares, is a dangerous, it's going to be very dangerous to the wheat? Yes, the master sees. But the master also knows something, that if, as long as we have harvest time, when the harvest time comes, the tares will disappear. And I'll tell you what it means. So I gave you an example. An example is a woman in church received God's word. She took God's word and said, the word of God says that by his stripes I'm healed. And God told her that he was going to heal her. And she kept on holding on to God's word. But somewhere along the line, she allowed the doctors and everybody to tell her that she was going to die. And there was no way that she was going to live. And so she allowed these tares to be sowed in her mind, and she started believing it. And so the tares started competing with the wheat, which is the word of God. So the doubt started competing with God's word. And so gradually the word that she held so dear to her began to die, and the tares began to sprout out. But how do you take out the tares, or the doubt, away from the wheat? And the master says don't, because what he's trying to say is let it maintain, you know. And sometimes the way to stop these things is to maintain. And what do I mean by maintain? I'll explain. Whilst you are going through the motion of believing God's word to be healed, You need to maintain, whilst the doubt is there, try and hold firmly to God's word, because the doubt is always going to be there, because the physical torment, because you're going through a torment of, let's say, cancer, right? And your whole body seems to be deteriorating, and everybody's telling you that the word of God says, by his stripes, I'm healed. But your body is deteriorating. Your body is not getting any better. You look at your body and you look at the word of God, and it's contrary. How do you get rid of what it's on your body? Because you can't do that. And so what the word of God is telling you is to maintain, whilst the body is still deteriorating, you still hold on to God's word, which says that you are healed. And how will the doubt leave? And I'll tell you what, the Bible says, the wheat will be separated from the tares after the harvest. In other words, whilst you hold on to God's word, after the time when you received your healing, the doubt will go away because you've received the healing, because that's harvest time. The day that you keep on saying, no, God is not going to heal me from cancer. There's no way God is going to heal me from cancer. My body is deteriorating. God, the word of God is telling you, look, God is going to do it. God is going to do it. You were believing God for a certain job. The word of God says, God is going to do it. God is going to do it. But you are still jobless. You're still in the house. You still have no money coming in. Nothing is happening. And the word of God says, keep on, hold on to it. And the doubt is coming from the fact that you are jobless. But what the Bible's telling us, during harvest time, that doubt will leave. Why? Because God would have answered your prayer about you receiving the job, you receiving your healing. And once you receive your healing, the doubt goes away. The doubt goes away when harvest comes. And I want to tell you today, harvest is coming, and there is a need for you to maintain. Maintaining is so important. When you keep your balance, you keep strong in God's word, because the harvest is coming. And when the harvest comes, the doubt will disappear. The only reason why the doubt is still there is because the harvest hasn't come yet. But if you keep on holding on to the seed, you keep on holding on to the wheat, you allow the wheat, you keep on watering that wheat, you keep on watering it, you keep on providing nutrients for it, you keep on receiving. Although sometimes when you keep on receiving, the tear seems to be tearing apart that wheat. And although that is happening, the Bible tells us that we should endure to the end. So you keep on maintaining, you keep on holding on to the seed. And although it looks like that seed is going to die, it won't die, because harvest time is coming soon and the doubt will disappear. This is what the difference comes in between the follower and the disciple. The follower just gets the seed and allows it to die. The follower does not maintain strong enough to wait and see the harvest. But the disciple maintains long enough so that he can see the harvest. It is when we see the harvest that we become witnesses of Jesus, because then you say, Jesus did that, and Jesus did that, and the Bible is true. I have experienced it. You do not get to that point until you receive a harvest. Now, we have too many Christians that have no testimony of a harvest. And because they don't have a testimony of a harvest, they don't understand that God does come through regardless of how much tares is in your life. And I don't care how much tares that is in your life, I'm telling you, if you maintain, that wheat will not die. That word of God that has been promised to you will not die. Thank you for this podcast. I'm Pastor Josh. Amen.